All right, hello. It is so good to have you here with us tonight. Welcome to Fellowship and our 2021 Christmas program. We are delighted that you have chosen to be here, and we appreciate your attendance. We're about to get started, and let me just call your attention to your program guide for a couple of things, and then also just to let you know, if you are coming up and you are going to be speaking, you need a mic, so make sure that you grab, come over here, I'll be sitting over here, make sure that I'm able to give you a mic so you can use a mic. If there's more than one, then we need both of you to have a mic. Even if you're singing, you say, I've got a loud voice, well, we want everyone to hear you. So make sure you use a mic, okay? With that said, you have your program guide before you. Hopefully, there is a slight amendment, okay? So I had a boo-boo. I had a couple of things I had to take care of today. I had one that I had to take off. Miss Pam was going to be doing a play tonight, but that fell through. She's got a little sickly child, so she's not able to be here. And so then I removed her, but then I was made aware of one that I failed to get in. So invariably, I always do that. There's always a lost email or text message or something that happens. And so let me get you to take, especially those who are participating, and if you will look down to Jingle Bells, about close to two-thirds of the way down the list, you'll see that that's the Chimes presentation with the youth, Jingle Bells, and following it is O Holy Night. In between there, if you want to pencil in or just be aware, I've already communicated this with Dustin and Luana and them. And so if you will write in Jared Hill, he is going to be singing a song for us tonight. Do you hear what I hear? And right now I don't hear anything, which is a good thing. So, no, I'm just kidding. It's a good song, and I'm excited. I'm looking forward to it. I know he's going to do a great job. But that's the write-in. That's the only adjustments that I have. So let me say to this, as I do each year, this is a really simple format. But as you see, there is a schedule to follow. It's not a timed schedule, but an orderly schedule. And so if you are part of the program, just be aware of who is up. And be aware of who you follow. So when your time comes, you are able to quickly move up to the stage and make your presentation and then move off the stage in a quick fashion so we can continue the program. As you see, we are back to 19 presentations tonight. So we would rather not spend 5 minutes in transition from one presentation to the other. So let's make that a smooth transition. Everyone be ready when it's your turn. Go right up to the stage and we'll get rolling, okay? Thank you so much for all who are participating in our presentations tonight. I am excited about all that you are going to be able to enjoy and experience. I trust it to be a great blessing to you. And again, I'm thankful for everyone who's participating. For those of you who are not participating, thank you for coming. And again, I hope that you thoroughly enjoy it. May the songs, the skits, and all that is part of our Christmas program be a great blessing and a source of encouragement and help to you as we embrace this Christmas season. So, before we get rolling, let's pause for just a brief moment of prayer, and then we will go. All right, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for loving us, and we thank you for this opportunity to be here tonight. And I know that there are lots of different songs and events that are going to be taking place tonight, and I suspect that probably it's easy for us to come to an event like this and think that we are coming to be entertained. And I know that some of it will be entertaining, but Lord, our purpose tonight is not to just have a laugh or to get a chuckle and to enjoy being in a service like that, but our purpose tonight is to glorify you. Our purpose tonight is to be reminded of you and your love and your sacrifice for us. Yeah. Our purpose tonight is to reflect upon the wonderful gift that Christmas means and what we celebrate at this Christmas time. So Lord, I pray that you would just draw our attention to you and what this Christmas is all about. And I pray that in every song that every person is involved in, every skit, reading, whatever it is that we do tonight, I pray, Lord, that you would be exalted. I pray that you would give courage and strength, and I pray that you would guide and bless each one who participates, whether they're playing the chimes or doing a song or whatever. And I pray that you would use it in such a way, Lord, to magnify your name. And I pray that you would just draw our hearts in line with you, and that we would once again be in awe and reminded of your wonder, your power, and your love. May you begin that even now. Help us to not be distracted by anything or anyone, and help us not to be a distraction for anyone as well. And God, may you bless everything that's done and said here tonight. Help us to remember that we are at church and we are here to worship you. And God, I pray that you would be pleased and exalted. And we ask your blessings on everything and everyone here in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Well, let me again remind you that we have your presentation or your guide before you. Please, again, make sure that you are reading and to be aware of when you come up next. And when it's your turn, just make your way right up to the stage, okay? And Miss Lydia, I have that video. If you will go ahead and get that video. I'm going to start a little bit differently for you tonight. And actually, if you'll look on the back of your program guide, you see a very familiar character. And the title of that is What Christmas is All About. Maybe you've seen that, heard that, familiar with that, and certainly goes along with our text and our message this morning. And in just a moment, I am going to have Lydia to play this very short video. As you see, it is a minute and 18 seconds long. But I want to call you to do this for me. As she pushes the button to play, I want you to pay close attention to what Linus says. And I also want you to pay close attention to what Linus does. Somewhere along the way, I'm not going to tell you where, but somewhere along the way, Linus is going to drop his blanket. See if you catch it. And then we'll come back to it right after the video. All right, Miss Lydia.
Isn't there anyone who knows what Christmas is all about?
Sure, Charlie Brown. I can tell you what Christmas is all about. Lights, please. And there were in the same country shepherds, abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. Lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them. The glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. He shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God, and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
That's pretty simple, right? Did you catch it? Yeah. When did he drop his blanket? Yeah, when he said, the angel said, fear not, and then told why not to fear. Somebody tell me what the blanket meant to and for Linus.
Security.
It's his security. That was his security blanket. Linus and his blanket forever are entwined. In that moment, as he shared the message of the angel, fear not, he turned loose of his security blanket. Now, maybe that's subtle, maybe it's accidental, maybe it's intentional, maybe it's a great hidden message. But for us tonight, it certainly is a message I want to relay to you, and that is, fear not. Linus understood that that was what the angel said as the message was proclaimed about the birth of our Savior. And that gives us reason to have hope, that gives us reason to trust, that gives us reason to not fear.
Amen.
I have a very short couple of verses I want to share with you, and then we will proceed. But I want you to understand that the phrase, do not be afraid, is a command that is in God's Word. And as I researched it, it is found in 28, at least 28 of the 66 books of the Bible. It's not just a statement, but is this command, do not be afraid. I think that God really was trying to speak a clear message to us, don't you? Let me remind you of just a very, 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 very few of those select passages. Matthew 10:28-31 says, don't fear those who kill the body but are not able to kill the soul. Rather, fear him who is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. Aren't two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them falls to the ground without your Father's consent. But even the hairs of your head have all been counted. So, don't be afraid. You are worth more than any sparrow. Isn't that good?
Amen.
What a message. Matthew 28:5-6. The angel told the women, don't be afraid because I know you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has risen just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Mm-hmm. Boy, what an important time to hear the message, do not be afraid.
Yeah.
2 Timothy 1:7. Oh, many of you have this passage memorized. We are told by Paul, for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. And then finally, Revelation 1:17-18 says, when I saw him, I fell at his feet like a dead man. He laid his right hand on me and said, don't be afraid. I am the first and the last and the living one. I was dead, but look, I am alive forever and ever. And I hold the keys to death and Hades. As a child of God, we have every reason to trust in Him and to not be afraid.
Amen.
And this Christmas is a great reminder of the hope that we have and the reason why we, as believers, do not have to fear. And so may God bless you this evening and may He remove your fear as you are reminded of His wonderful, powerful, and gracious love. All right?
Thank you.
Press play. There are so many songs about Christmas. The reindeer, the lights, and the gifts. We sing chestnuts are roasting and marshmallows toasting. And here comes old jolly Saint Nick. Now don't get me wrong, I sure love all those songs. But one holiday gets left out. You see, no one remembers a song for November. That's gonna change starting now. Gobble, gobble one.
Gobble, gobble two.
Gobble, gobble me. Gobble, gobble you. Listen to me now. Gobble, gobble three. Gobble, gobble four. Gobble, gobble please. Can I have some more? A straw in the gravy bowl.
Yeah.
I'ma eat a dozen dinner rolls. Stretchy pants on, that's how I roll. No judgment here, no judgment here. Grandma's pants down, passing gas. Oh, we got pumpkin candles burning just for that. Someone brought up politics, now everybody's mad. But you can't be mad when the whole world's singing. Gobble, gobble one. Gobble, gobble two. Come on. Gobble, gobble me. Gobble, gobble you.
Somewhat familiar with, but it's not one that we typically sing in a rotation here at church. It's not as familiar to most people, but it is number 141 in your hymnal if you want to see it as we go through it. There's not a whole lot of background that we know about this song compared to a lot of Christmas carols that we sing. May date back as far as 1500 in Germany, and if you look at the bottom of the page, if you're looking at the hymnal, on 141. It's a German melody, with that much we do know, arranged by Hugo Jungst, who I probably mispronounced his name. He was born in the mid-1800s, so we know it's at least that old. It's been translated, obviously, then from German. The first two stanzas of the song were translated by Theodore Baker, who was kind of a contemporary of Hugo Jungst. The notes that I have here say we typically only sing between two and four of the original nine stanzas.
We're not
going to
sing.
We're not going to sing all nine. Not only are we not going to sing all nine, and they're printed here, I'm not going to read all nine either. Only one of these nine is actually in our hymn book. So there's three in our hymnal that are nine. So I don't know where they got their nine, So now we know there's at least 12. So, a little background on a kind of an unknown hymn that now is still sort of unknown. So there you go. But you can feel free to follow along if you want to.
While by the sheep we watched at night, glad tidings brought an angel bright. How great our joy!
Great our joy!
Joy, joy, joy!
Joy, joy, joy!
Praise we the Lord in heaven on high! Praise we the Lord in heaven on high! There shall be born, so he did say, in Bethlehem a child today. How great our joy!
Great our joy!
Joy, joy, joy!
Joy, joy, joy!
Praise we the Lord in heaven on high! Praise we the Lord in heaven on high! This gift of God we'll cherish well, that ever joy our hearts shall fill. How great our joy!
Great our joy!
Joy, joy, joy!
Joy, joy, joy!
Praise we the Lord in heaven on high! Praise we the Lord in heaven on high! Joy, joy, joy!
Joy, joy, joy!
Praise we the Lord in heaven on high! Praise we the Lord in heaven on
thank you. I remember when people used to say things like Merry Christmas to each other. Everybody said Merry Christmas! Hey, Merry Christmas to you, Mr. Lowenstein! You know why? Because it wasn't about a religion. It was about something as a culture we thought was so valuable that we'd all do it together, even if I disagreed with the religion behind it, because it was good for all of us instead of just me. Well, what do you say now? Happy holidays. See, I just say happy holidays because I don't want to say Christmas because you don't believe in Christmas because I don't want to offend you.
It's called Christmas.
So, and Mom, has been so mean. She makes me do homework and makes me do chores, and I never get to play my games or have any fun.
Well, you know, Mom's just trying to teach you a little responsibility. I know it's not very much fun right now, but when you grow up, you'll appreciate it.
Hi, Anthony. See you later.
Oh, hey, is that your friend?
Oh, yeah, he's new here. I like him.
Well, I'm glad you got a new friend.
Hey, look, it's Brother Doug.
Hey, you know that?
You know he's nice, but all he talks about is someone is coming to save us. People think he's crazy and it's embarrassing.
Sweetie, he's talking about the coming of our Lord. He's not crazy. God's giving him information that he's trying to teach us so that we can be prepared when he comes.
I don't understand. Why do we need a Savior? What is he going to do for us?
Well, it was told long ago that he would be born a baby and he would grow up and he would be this great and awesome king. There would be no one like him before or after. He's going to come and save us from our sins, and we're going to just be so thrilled that we have an eternal king.
Wow, when is he coming?
Well, I'm not sure, but I think it's going to be soon.
I can't wait. Maybe he'll make us rich, and maybe we can hire someone to do my chores.
Well, I don't really think that's going to be his purpose in coming. You know, we're really all blessed. If you really think about it, I know you have to work hard, and you have to get up early, and Mom makes you do stuff, but you're really blessed. You know, you have a home, you have food to eat, you don't want for anything, and if you look around this town, there's a lot of people who are living on the streets. They have nothing, so you're really truly blessed if you think about it.
I guess so, but I sure am tired of getting up early and feeding that mean old goat.
Well, you know, if you didn't have that goat, you wouldn't have milk for breakfast in the morning.
I guess so. Hey, why is it that when I complain, you always find something good?
Well, you know, we all complain all the time. We're just human nature for us to complain. But if all you see is the bad in the world, you're going to miss all the great blessings that Jesus gives us every day. And we're blessed. I'm blessed because I have this time with you today. So I'm a blessing of my own. So, you know, we can always complain about anything, anytime.
Yes, just think of Aunt Pam. She is never happy. She's a mean old thing. She's always yelling at us kids, and we don't do anything to her.
Well, you know, Miss Pam, she's really had a hard life. She's lost all of her money. She's lost her family. I think Miss Pam's usually just sad most of the time. Not really mean, just sad.
I don't remember that.
Well, that was a long time before you were born.
Oh, I will tell my friends, and maybe we can try and make her smile.
Well, I wouldn't expect too much too soon out of there. She's been that way a long time.
Well, then, it's time someone try and help her. If God can send his son to help us, then maybe we can do something for him.
Out of the mouths of babes.
Hey, I'm not a baby.
Oh, I know, I'm sorry.
Can I go meet my friends now? We're going to go play some ball.
Sure, you go have fun, but try not to get hit in the eye this time. You had a knock out for 2 weeks last time.
I won't. I'm better at catching now. Thanks, Nate. I always learn something when I talk to you. Sometimes I don't want to, and then I have to do something about it. But I guess it's good. I always feel better after.
All right. Well, you go have a good time, but try to be careful, okay?
I will.
Test of the emergency broadcast system. I think I hear.
Has this been an actual get up here.
To the little lamb, do you see what I see? Way up in the sky, little lamb, do you see what I see? A star, dancing in the night with a tail as big as a kite. With a tail as big as a kite. Said the little lamb to the shepherd boy, do you hear what I hear? Ringing through the sky, shepherd boy, do you hear what I hear? A song, high above the trees, with a voice as big as the sea, with a voice as big as the sea. Said the shepherd boy to the mighty king, do you know what I know? In your palace war, mighty king, do you know what I know? A child, shivers in the cold. Let us bring him silver and gold. Let us bring him silver and gold. Said the king to the people, he will bring us goodness and light. He will bring us goodness.
I'm going to say a verse first. The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God."
Oh, holy night, the stars are bright and shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long may the world in sin and error shining, to be of him and his soul.
Thank you. doing this alone.
Feliz Navidad, something to pep us up because it's been a rough year for a lot of us here.
Mary, do you know?
Thank you.
You'll see me before you leave. Thanks for coming. God bless you. You are dismissed.